How the linear accelerator works. All body cells can be damaged or killed by radiation, but tumor cells are more sensitive to radiation than normal cells. Radiation therapy uses this principle to damage beyond repair or kill the abnormal cancer cells in a tumor. Successful radiation therapy depends on the ability of the linear accelerator, or LINAC, to deliver a tumoricidal dose of radiation to the tumor, while ensuring minimal radiation of normal tissue. The LINAC accurately produces, monitors, controls, and conforms the radiation beam. LINAC control. One computer system controls both the LINAC and the multi-leaf collimator. This eliminates dosimetric errors due to communication delays. It also ensures synchronization between the delivered dose and the multi-leaf collimator position, allowing complex deliveries such as intensity modulated radiation therapy and volumetric modulated arc therapy. All electromagnets, steering, and focusing coils are digitally controlled. All mechanical positions of flight tube, filters, and foils are automatically selected from the control console, and all radiation beam settings are grouped in calibration blocks for each energy. These are stored digitally on the LINAC hard disk for flexible and easy beam adjustment, calibration, and servicing.
So what is proton therapy? Proton therapy is a type of treatment that uses an external beam of radiation to kill cancerous cells. Traditional forms of radiation, such as X-rays, can destroy many types of cancers when given at high enough doses. However, traditional types of radiation are difficult to control. Because of this, much of their energy is spent entering the body. Radiation is deposited in normal tissue that surrounds the targeted tumor and passes beyond the tumor through the body. This lack of precision causes radiation to damage healthy tissues, sometimes so much so that an adequate dose cannot be delivered to the tumor. Protons, on the other hand, can be controlled to deliver maximum energy at the tumor site. Very little radiation is wasted entering the body, and the precision of protons prevents radiation from continuing beyond the tumor site. This level of control is unique to proton therapy and makes it superior to other forms such as IMRT, gamma knife, and tomotherapy. Proton therapy is also referred to as a type of conformal radiation therapy. Conformal means the beam can be shaped to match the targeted tumor. This enables the entire tumor to be treated, but spares surrounding tissue.
Protons are really the only form of radiation we have presently that allows us to control inside the patient what the radiation does, and we can control it starting and stopping.
People ask me, where is radiation therapy going? And one of the things I look for is the holy grail, which is adoptive radiation therapy. We figure out on a daily basis where the cancer is, maybe with a CT, probably with something a lot more sophisticated in terms of functional images. We put the patient on the table and replant it every day to treat just where the cancer is, leave the normal tissue alone, and have 100% success. Adoptive radiation therapy, I expect to be here in 10 to 15 years. I think in 5 years, we'll be making steps towards replanting on a weekly basis, maybe with not the precision we'll have in 20 years, but I think that the future of radiation therapy and the future effectiveness and the future in terms of limiting toxicities is just going to be amazing.
Thank you. No shot at any. Wait, coming at 0.35. I see them.